Yesterday's first day of the seventh month on our Maker's Restored calendar was a magnificent waypoint indicator that he gave to us in the testimony of his word. This year above all years in the past. Amazing. Amazing. This year's memorial acclamations was quite the day with how he marked it being day number one of the first 65 days of his chapter 7, Isaiah chapter 7, Emmanuel, Manchal, Meher, Shalal, Kush, Baz prophecy, a day for a year of Ephraim being filled with terror. Amazing how it was 669 days, Ephraim, it was Ephraim number of days, stroke number 669 from Hurricane Michael and such, but yet he has continued to hold this back on a grand scale. Of course, there was still even the Magnificent Mile being rioted in Chicago and stuff, and amazing all the unrest that continues to unfold in this chief seat of the scattered descendants of Israel and the rest of the world, per his Haggai, aka Man of the Feast, 24th day of the ninth month, signature ring, his Isaiah chapter 55 signature ring that he's put upon my hand. But truly amazing, it's all amazing how this is unfolding. And it is going to continue to accelerate during these 65 days. We're going to continue to talk about that, but right now my mind is set on 7 days from yesterday, on the 188th day of the year. I'll expand on his restored calendar. I'll expand upon that as we move forward here as well. But he did indeed mark yesterday in phenomenal ways, and one I'm going to add to here today in this video, a big one. But he did not send forth the Emmanuel, Manchal, Meher, Shalal, Kush, Baz last night, like I thought. Instead, he sent forth steamboat number 111. Continued on with his justify cycle, with his number 25 of this third year, according to how he marks his days on his restored calendar, according to when he sent the first one on the 23rd day of the first month a couple years ago, the 25th eruption of this third year. And that's amazing too, because we're about ready to enter into the second year of another period of time, to get ready to end the second year of his altar being uncovered on this year's Memorial of Acclamations, 9 days from yesterday. But amazing. So he started showing me things yesterday where I didn't think he was going to send forth the Manchal, but I still stayed awake last night and stayed in the Queen's tent, hoping that he could, and figuring that he would send forth the Manchal on the same day he sent forth his only begotten son on the Memorial of Acclamations. But it looks like he might not send him until the end of this, which is 9-5, when he sends forth the faithful witness twins, Zechariah and Uriah. If he does so, this will be 23 days late, according to the 266th day for Meher and Rachel. It'll be 19 days late according to the 280th day. 23:19, I'll do a new thing in the land. Amazing. And I'll expand upon that maybe another video, maybe even in this video. But 23:19. And the 9-5 is the 266th day for Zechariah and Uriah, the faithful witness twins. So we'll see. It's all amazing how this is unfolding. But maybe Emmanuel, the first day of the 65, his only begotten son, and Emmanuel, the last day of the 65, that certainly makes sense. But I'll be staying awake on the 266th day, which will be 8-12, which is 9-19 on Satan's calendar. And I'll be staying awake if he don't send him forth in. I'll be staying awake with no wine that night. And no wine 4 days later on 9-23, 3 years after he sent the Virgin of the Sky sign, which is the 9-23 on Satan's calendar, is 8-16 on our Maker's Restored calendar. And, of course, like I said, plus 19 days will be 9-5, but amazing. It's all amazing. The whole thing's amazing. So, you know, whatever, call me a false prophet all you want. YEHWEH just continues to shorten the days, and this is just what it is. And you know, otherwise, no man would survive, and it's amazing how he continues to do so. But we're staring down the barrel of day number 188 now, and even the fifth day of this month has got some significance to it with Elijah prophecy. I'll expand upon that maybe in this video, maybe another. It's not in my notes, but I might get to it. The steamboat number 111 for those that justify. Number 111, 25 of the third year with the 25 men with their back towards YEHWEH's house, you stealing from our Maker. Sent it forth at 2306 Yellowstone time yesterday. I'll talk about the significance of that in a bit. 2306 Yellowstone time, 2206 Arizona time, where YEHWEH's house is. But the interval between number 110 and between 110 and this 111 eruption was 6 days, 13 hours, and 9 minutes. And I'll expand upon that too. But briefly, 613, he caused the wife that's fled in the wilderness upon the dual wings of the great vulture and I to get married on before his face, it's on 6/13 on Satan's calendar, over 14 years ago. Amazing. In 9 minutes, that's 9 days from yesterday, would be the two smooth stone anniversary of his house being uncovered, his altar being uncovered, and what's transpired there with the one great evil and such. All amazing. But T-minus 9 days from yesterday, the 7/10 waypoint, day of covering. But by the way, will be its own 280th day. 280th day. Yesterday was the 280th day. That's another reason why I thought he sent forth Meher and Rachel. But 280th day from the three measures of leavening on 9/21. Well, 9 days later, he caused the one great evil. So 280 days from the one great evil of his house being destroyed, poor Isaiah chapter 27, on account of you stealing from our Maker, is this coming year's day of a covering. Amazing. Two smooth stone anniversary of his house being uncovered. Day number 721 of his house being uncovered. 720 days in 2 years, but 720 days of it being uncovered would be 7/9. Amazing. 7/19 will be this 188th day, July 19th. I'll expand upon that. But when I checked this morning early, night watches, I was laying there meditating on the Queen's bed, as I stayed with her in her tent in case he sent forth the children. But it was 6 hours and 55 minutes ago when I checked, when I seen it turn off. Amazing. Amazing, because I'm going to get into what 6:55 means in a little bit, too. That strong number, how it ties into Nebuchadnezzar and such. But these three calculations yield 252 for the 252 copper censers, Aaron censer, Korah censer, and those 250 princes censers. I said a couple videos ago that it was beaten into the golden covering for the altar. Now it was a copper covering, but I just wasn't thinking and slipped there. But copper covering, those copper censers. Amazing. Going to go into, going to be that the copper, the feet, excuse me, the going to go into the belly of copper here, like barrel, but I'm not going to expand upon that. But Nebuchadnezzar's image here in this video still, I'll expand upon that. But this steamboat eruption was up 111 again, an eighth stroke, 888. Wow, I'm going to get into the significance of that too in a bit. 888, how that ties into all this. 888, wow, eight strokes of 10. And Solomon hewed out those stones for Yehweh's house. The stones of great stones, eight cubits and 10 cubits. Now, eight of 10 of these steamboat eruptions. And this steamboat eruption, why is steamboat significant? Is one is that Yellowstone, which he goes back to the first vision he gave to me. And two is that steamboat mattress with how he started to bring forth the Emmanuel Manchild, Meher Shalal Kushbash. You have to watch the earlier videos and how I inherited that mattress when the younger wife of Zechariah chapter 5 fled back to Babylon, to Egypt. Amazing. Against his instructions not to. But the eighth bottle, of the poured out ones from Adam, those eight bottles of seven shepherds and eight poured out ones from Adam. I'm going to expand upon the seven shepherds in the next video. But the eighth bottle of the eight poured out ones from Adam were the night before on 8/8 on Satan's calendar. The great Meher Shalal Kushbash Meher. 8/8, the eighth bottle. Now we got the next day, the steamboat eruption, 8/8/8, the eighth of these 10 eruptions. And the 11 eruptions encompassing them. But 8/8 and the 10 eruptions later, there was a space 111 apart, eight strokes. And one time there's braced 45, I think, and one time with the number, I'm talking about the final number that those three calculations yield. Other time it was 981. So it was five strokes of 111, followed by a stroke of 45 separating them, followed by two strokes of 111, followed by 981, followed by 111 again, this eighth stroke. Amazing. Amazing, amazing, amazing. Amazing. So anyway, no wine that night was the seventh, excuse me, yeah, that night of that bottle, that on 6:30 that night was the 777th night of all wine, no wine. Amazing. 777th night, parallel the 770 years of Lamech and stuff, which he says if Cain should be smitten, dual sevens for slaying a man, and Lamech 77s. It's amazing, that whole prophecy too. He tells his dual wives, listen, you dual wives of Lamech, and because he had hurt an offspring. Wow, amazing. Is it his own offspring? I'll probably expand upon that in another video too. But you have hurt an offspring. The Emmanuel Manchild, Meher Shalal Kushbash, and not only him, his three siblings. Not only that, you've hurt your own offspring, burning them up in the lake that burns with fire and brimstone. Teach them lies he has been to. But no wine last night at the queen's tent when the steamboat eruption went off. And that means that, and by the way, the horror of great darkness, both wicks were out, very, very rare. Both wicks were out on that night. And recently, both wicks were out the king's tent one time too, very rare. But anyway, that means that if I don't have wine on the next delivery waypoint, number, which would be the 266th day for Meher and Rachel, and I don't have wine the next delivery waypoint, that'll take the supply in the king's wine cellar to 9/11 of all things. Honor makers restore counter. 9/11. Gotta be kidding me. But it was the eighth night that at least one had been out with this 888. One night, one had been out with the parallel and all the eighth day, the circumcision, but it was at least eight nights in a row that at least one had been out with the king's tent. And one of those nights, both wicks was out, the third of those eight nights. That has significance too. Wow. I mean, I can't tell you, I don't think there's ever been two nights in a row where one wick's been out at my tent. That's amazing. Eight nights, and no wind, no weather to cause it, no whatever. New wicks every night, new wicks from the same batch of wicks. The oil's the same, everything's the same, all the same. I'm talking about the flame of there. But three out of four were out last night. Amazing. One was still going at my tent, although I wasn't in my tent, of course. The calculations of the steamboat eruption are incredible. I'm going to share some of them with you. But the first calculation I go to get that number that yielded in that 252, and the 252 also parallels the 252 sacrifices for those 12 days that were offered up to YEHWEH when they dedicated his house in the wilderness. 252, those 12 rods of Israel. And we give to as the numbers, those counts. And it parallels other things too. 2,520 days in 7 years on his restored calendar. 25,200 days in 70 years according to the days of one king, and so on, and other stuff. I can't reinvent the wheel in all these videos, so. And I only think of a handful of stuff sometimes because I'm concentrating on other stuff in these videos. But anyway, in doing that first calculation, I mirror it back. Yesterday was 8-9 on Satan's calendar, so I mirror it back to 8-9 of the year 6000 last year, the year of the ram's horn release of debts on our Maker's restored calendar. That day was 9-22 of 2019, which parallels 9-22, the date of 2010, when YEHWEH brought us to Greece. Amazing. That night we got there, 922, and the next calculation goes to 6001, but I'll go into this one first. But 8-9 of 2010 was the beginning of the first tier of 1260 days, which did not equal 42 months. But there was a 613 day offset between those two 1260 day counts, parallel on the 613 marriage and other things as well. I think that was actually the day that the silver trumpet got there. The first silver trumpet was blown on 6/15, the day we actually got married, the anniversary of the day we actually got married before Satan's, on Satan's calendar, before YEHWEH's faces, on Satan's calendar years earlier on 6/15. And I'm sorry if I get talking fast, I'll try to slow down. I know it's getting long already and I haven't even flipped my little quarter of a page here. But that 8-9 waypoint is amazing all the way through this. And I'm not going to go into all that, but there's a bunch of stuff with it, a bunch of stuff with it, how it parallels 8-9 on Satan's calendar, YEHWEH's calendar, the great Meher Shalal Kush Baz Mir. I'm not going to go into any of that. But that 1260-day period ended on 11-8 of 74 on our Maker's restored calendar, the day his spirit entered into me. What? It was 11-7 as the dawning of the day, dawning and at 11-8. You got to be kidding me. That 1260 was that. But on that day, on 8-9-6000 last year, we're T-minus 45 days to 9/24, the shake the dual heavens and the earth waypoint. Yesterday, on this eruption, we were T-minus 45 days to the 280th day. Wow. Yesterday, we're T-minus 45 days to the 280th day, according to that second messenger of blood delivery, second messenger of blood that YEHWEH sent with the elder wife, four with the younger wife. And of course, she continued to have her issues, seven of them total, and then they seem to have stopped. So, and major issues, though. This is like her womb wasn't closed. It's amazing. I haven't expanded upon that, and I'm not going to get into it. I got too many windows open in this video already. So, but T minus 45 days yesterday to the 280 day. Back then, last year, 8-9-6000, T minus 45 days to 9/24. And that waypoint was a whole bunch of stuff. It was, I thought I had some things written down, but I guess I didn't. Yeah, I did. I do. It was the day number 390, the altar being uncovered. I'll probably do a separate video for how 390, the year, the month, the day, the hour, everything lines up with 9/5. But I don't want to be forward thinking, because I do believe he's going to be, it's going to, the travailing is going to increase before then. 9-4 will be the one great day that he removes the iniquity. But the travailing is going to increase before then. But I'll talk about like how the 490 and stuff, all these things tie into that date in other videos, because it's incredible. It says, I don't want to be too forward thinking, because he keeps putting so much urgency on the here and the now, like he did yesterday. I thought he was going to do this. But it was the day number 390, the altar was uncovered. That was huge. It was the last day of summer. That was pretty big. 132nd night on the steamboat mattress that his second son of his holy anointing oil was on the steamboat mattress of those 156 days. 132 parallels, 1211, because it's 1211s when Rabshakeh came the first stroke to deliver that piece of paper telling us, they're giving us the evacuation order, eviction order. Amazing. 922 of 6001 was the second calculation. I go to 922 6001, which is yet to be. It's in the future. And that day will be on 10/29, 2020 on Satan's calendar. 10/29 was the of 10/29 on Yahweh's calendar of the year 5776, which was December 26th, was the first time he caused me to approach near to him three strokes a day, per his servant Daniel, approaching near to him three strokes a day. Ended up with him getting thrown into the lion's den. And I'm going to expand upon how that ties into Nebuchadnezzar as we go. I haven't got to that. But Strong's number 888 is used one place. It's in Daniel, where Nebuchadnezzar was displeased that they were going to throw Daniel in the lion's den, but he had to go along with it because it was his law, his law. So, but he was displeased, is the word, displeased, used one stroke. How displeased is YEHWEH that you is at you for what you that you reflected his second son of his holy anointing oil in the manner you have. Of course, it's all in his word, but that's how displeased is he? 888. Wow, yesterday's a big eruption, folks. And this eighth day of this seventh month is a big day. Day number 188. Wow, according to his restored calendar. Now just 6 days from today. 7 days from yesterday. Seven strokes. But the number yielded the 252. I talked about the significance of that. Strong's number 252 is used one place. It's Aramaic for brother. It's used in Ezra 7:18. That has its own significance, 7:18. But it's where the king Artaxerxes was telling Ezra that him and his brothers could do with what they want with the rest of the silver and the gold. Wow, how that ties into Nebuchadnezzar's, that image, the head of gold and stuff. I'm going to keep expanding on this. We go on this video, and it's going to be brief because this is already getting long. But I told you 6 hours and 55 minutes. Strong's number 655 used one place. Proverbs 25:11. A word spoken upon the right time is what it means. A word spoken upon the right time. They translate the two words upon and 655. They translate it something else. I forget. Like appropriate or something. But you look it up. It's a word spoken and it's two words. Upon 59:20-21. Upon 65:55. Upon the right time. See, it hasn't been the right time. Yesterday wasn't the right time. He's shortening the days. Upon the right time. The right time for him to let this loose on a grand scale, isn't it? But he's letting it loose, folks, more and more every day. Look at the COVID circumcision 19. Look at the riots and stuff happening across the country. They're not going away, are they? They're increasing. Oh, but we can go without face masks and stuff. The wife just fled, read a story this morning where a woman's being threatened, a young girl's being threatened for doing a picture in a locker room of people not wearing a face mask. You can't even be separated for diseases from affecting people. Go home and get their grandparents sick and they die, but you don't care. You can't wear your mask, can you? That's funny, a lot of you. That's funny. She's being threatened for taking a picture of the crowded hallways in a school. Wow, it's a sick world. But what is she even doing there? She should be separated from the people. But of course, she'd be in trouble, so she's afraid to not go there. But what are the rest of you doing out in the world? You need to be separated to our Maker. And you watch this thing mutate into some really deadly strain. But you don't care about your grandparents. Oh, I'm going to go and whatever. You don't care about the people that might have a health thing. They're going to die. I got to have my freedom. Whatever. You got an issue, you're supposed to be separated. Even 7 days after you're healed from it. Amazing. An additional 7 day incubation period, if you will, to make sure you're over it. Yeah, whatever. Yeah. Yeah, amazing. Amazing what it's sick. And you people that are going out in the world without masks, you are amazingly bitterly obstinate, because this is just, first of all, it's nothing, but it still kills people. Of course, the flu, you should have not went out with the flu or a common cold. This is a little more contagious than that, but you shouldn't have went out in the world with those things. You should have been separated for anything. His word commands you to, but you don't care what his word says. Whatever. But at the right time, strong, 6 hours and 55 minutes ago, the right time. The right time is coming. Day number 188 be it. We'll see. Don't know. Be accused of saying for sure that it was, but that 188 day earthquake cycle, 188-day, those five earthquakes spaced 180 days apart, 188-day his feast cycle with the encompass the first day of the feast and the eighth day when his feast is extended, because the only way you can have a true day of the feast is to extend his feast to 14 days, talked about in other videos. 188 days of his feast cycle then. 613, Strong's number 613, used three places. It's used once in Ezra and two times in Daniel chapter 4, where in Daniel chapter 4 it's referring to the band that, of iron and copper that binds the stump. Nebuchadnezzar, for the seven strokes, it's an imprisonment term that means imprisonment, but an imprisonment band, the band of copper, paralleling that the number, the kingdom number 3 of copper and the kingdom number 4 of iron, with the 10 toes, clay and iron, mixed with clay. But the seven strokes of that prison, amazing. Seven strokes of 40 days is the 280 days that it takes on average to bring forth the man-child from the onset of a woman's last menstrual cycle. Amazing, seven strokes of that, but you translate it 7 years or whatever, but seven strokes or seven times, but seven strokes of 40 is 280. Yesterday was an incredible 280 day waypoint. I thought it was gonna be it, very possibly. And yeah, Rez, I said, very possibly. Very well possible in my letter even, and you say I'm a false prophet because nothing happened. Whatever. In other times I did think things were going to happen for sure, but I've worded things a little differently for the most part now, but it don't matter. It's just continued to shorten the days. You know, the reason I spoke that it was going to happen because of all the evidence he gave us, but then he gives us more evidence. And now I'm looking at another 280 days. 280 days from the destruction of his house per the chalk stones, per his Isaiah chapter 27 prophecy, on account of you stealing from our Maker, on his two smooth stone anniversary, day number 721 of his altar being uncovered, parallel in 721, the come and drink waypoint, the one little continuous of time. I'm going to span upon that here in a minute too, about as far as the one little continuous of time, 63 days to 924, seven strokes of 40, 280 days. But chapter 2 of Daniel, it talks about those 10 toes, and how this goes into a 10-day period is amazing. But and it takes us to day number 188, which is 708 on our Maker's restored calendar, which would be, I guess today's 810 on Satan's calendar, so we'd add 6. I guess that's 816 on Satan's calendar. Wow, I didn't even catch that. If I'm right, I guess it would be 816. 816 is the 280th day for the Emmanuel Manchild Meher Shalal Kushbaz. Say what? I didn't even catch that till just now. What? That's amazing. I think I'm right. I think 7-8 will be on 816, I'm sure. 6 days from today, and today's 810. Sure it would be, yeah. But anyway, back on 6-18, not that long ago, a few days ago, but 20 days out from there, we're 20 days out. Well, he tells, that's an amazing day, because that was the third day sprinkling of his house, for the third and seventh day sprinkling. Third day sprinkling, 6-18, among a whole bunch of other stuff he marked that day with. Not like he marked yesterday, and not like he's beginning to mark this 188 day now. But, and of course, 2 days later, the third day would be which would be the day of covering. 210, I mean 20, he'll come to a heap of 20 in Haggai. One little continuous time from 27-21, 21st day of the seventh month. One little continuous time, 63 days later, he gives us to the 24th day of the ninth month, those dual prophecies for those three times he lists the 24th day of the ninth month. This is amazing, because one of those prophecies says you come to a heap of 20 and there'll be 10. That's amazing, 20 and there'll be 10. Well, 10 days later into this 20-day count was 628. That day, I made the 63rd trek. The 63rd trek, 63 days from 721 to 924. I made the 63rd trek with the rolly thing. I hauled waters. I went down because the night before we'd gotten 50 gallons of waters hauled. The 62nd trip the night before, but it was food. Thanks, Victor. Victor supplied money for 10 buckets and 10 lids. They were ordered from separate companies, so it was 10 and 10 there too. But and also he supplied money for some fruit and milk and eggs and stuff for the wife that's fled in the wilderness. Rest of you haven't. One man a few weeks earlier spent some money for the website and stuff, and thank you too for that. But reality is I was able to get some supplies and potatoes and stuff, different things, and the milk and everything, and it was a full load to, even though it wasn't that much stuff, it was weight wise it was definitely a full load with the rolling thing, so I didn't haul any waters. Went back to the next day on 6/28, the day of those last two videos, but I was in kind of a hurry to get them done to go haul waters. I went down there to go haul the first load of waters. And I went to, that prophecy said, you come to a heap of 20, there'll be 10. It says you'll go to a wine vat to uncover 50, and there'll be 20, and there'll be 20 in the press, the wine press. Waters, turn the waters into blood, turn the waters into wine, wine symbolic of blood, wine press, blood, grapes of wrath. It's all there in previous videos. But I went to go uncover 50 gallons of wine slash blood. They were waters. Wine, turn the water. He sent me to turn the waters into blood. I went to uncover 50 gallons of wine. I was able to haul 10 gallons with the rolling thing of Ezekiel chapter 10. Excuse me. I had to think about that. But Ezekiel chapter 10. So I was able to haul 10 gallons, but we had 10 gallons left over. So I went to uncover, because they're covered with trees and stuff and camouflage, and I went to uncover 50 gallons of wine, turn the waters into blood, and there existed 20 in the wine press. Wow. 628. On the day, there was 10 days left to this 188. 20 become 10, 50 become 20. 20 gallons of water. So those 50 I was able to haul with the rolling thing. That day, on 628 with 10 left. That's amazing. 628, monster. Two smooth stone anniversary. The 600th day of me approaching near to him. Three strokes a day. Per those three strokes a day, it started on 1029 of 5776. Wow, that's amazing. Yesterday, steamboat eruption. 6 days, 13 hours, and 9 minutes. Strong's number 6139 is Ekronites. Used two places, but said it means the extermination in many, many previous videos, the eradication. But it actually, because you can inquire upon Beelzebub, the master of the flies, and then the Elohim of Ekron, the Elohim of extermination. So obviously flies get exterminated. But it actually means torn up by the roots. Torn up by the roots. Wow. Torn up by the roots. The great stump. And of course, Nebuchadnezzar is going to reign here again. No, he isn't reigning here. His kingdom isn't set up forever. Anyway, it's a prophecy. But going back to Daniel chapter 2, the head, fine gold, said it represents Nebuchadnezzar. The breast and the arms, silver, okay. Well, he's talking about representing the kingdom. 721, the gold and the silver are mine, says YEHWEH of hosts. How that ties into it, amazing. One little continuous time, 63 days later, 924, 63rd truck with the rolling thing per Ezekiel chapter 10. Wow. 50 become 20. Heap of 20 was 10 that day. 10 more days to the 188th day. Wow, but that brass and arms become silver. Of course, last night I was able to touch and look upon the wife that's fled into the wilderness's breasts. And they're growing, folks. They're growing. Their story came touch them, basically. But they're growing. These children are growing in the womb. But amazing. Amazing. Belly and thighs of copper, this kingdom, belly and thighs of copper. Now you say, my says brass. Well, I think it was the same as the Hebrew word for it's translated brass, which is copper. But I didn't look at that close, but I think it's copper. I'm pretty positive that the Hebrew word that's translated brass typically is copper, but this is no doubt an Aramaic word. But belly and thighs were copper, legs and iron, or legs of iron, and dual feet of iron and clay, 10 toes, 10 days from 628. Now keep in mind, of course, that ultimately represents back as a prophecy for the mother whore of Babylon, Rome, and her daughter whores, the daughter whores that came out from her. They're divided between two opinions, between who Kikwe is. They're divided anyway, and they won't stand because this stone is gonna, and I'll get to that in a second. But four kingdoms is what they represent. And these four kingdoms, okay, well, now you've got these four living creatures that are going to rule here on earth with the 127 princes. Wow, 123 of them will be man-childs, and I don't know how Rachel will figure into this, of those 127 princes. And Rachel would be 128, that has significance too. But, wow, that's amazing. She'd probably be my right hand, actually, the more I think about it, kind of like Ivanka Trump. She probably has more of the decision making with her dad than you think, but anyway, I don't know. But these four kingdoms came chaff of the summer threshing floor, scattered, referring to by Yahweh's spirit, by this one stone, the one stone, upon the one stone, the engraving. He's going to move the iniquity one day, says Zechariah chapter 3. Upon that, upon one stone will be the engraving thereof. Wow, this one stone comes down, yours truly, and smites this great image of Nebuchadnezzar. Wow. And this steamboat erupts in these numbers. You go back and listen to it, and there's more to it. There's more to it. I probably, who knows how long this video is already, but I try to keep them short for, so you, maybe at least a couple people might finish listening to them. But even that, I don't know. But all is the prophecy for the here and the now. It ties in with all the rest of it. It ties in with, you know, just to talk to a little bit about the lion's den and a little bit how it ties into it. And the chapter 4 prophecy with Nebuchadnezzar, with the stump and the seven strokes. There's a lot to this, a lot of dynamics, but it's all pointing to, now it's pointing to another 280-day period. The day of covering, 10th day of the month, third day from this 188th day, be the 190th day. Which 188th day ties into, of course, the mirror of the 280th day, 816. 816 on Satan's calendar, if I'm right. I think I am. And 816 on Yahweh's restored calendar, the great Meher Shalal Kush Baz Mir. Isaiah chapter 8:1, take that which pertains to the Emmanuel Manchild Meher Shalal Kush Baz and write it upon a great mirror. Look up the words for yourself. Folks, this is happening. This is happening. The stone is getting ready to smite you. And you're going to find out that you divided. You divided even who Yahweh is. And I could talk about this email. Maybe I'll do a third video today. I think I'm thinking about the way out here. About this man who wrote me. Think about this asteroid field coming. Just crazy how ridiculously divided you are on who Yahweh is. You say the Elohim of this book. Is the Elohim of Abraham, Isaac, and Israel. But then you follow one of countless different make-believe images of who he is, his character, and who his only begotten son are. That's crazy stuff. Get ready to be smitten.